Driving down Main Street in Johnson City, it was once home to the who's who of the village, including one of the original three Johnson brothers. On tonight's legacy landmark, Fox 40's Amy Hogan takes us inside the last standing home of the three Johnson brothers.
Heading down Main Street, the old high school on your left and Barber Memorial Home on your right.
The house was built in 1913.
It wasn't always a funeral home. The house at 428 Main Street blends in with the neighborhood, but it was the home of Harry L. Johnson and his wife, Sophie.
He was the youngest of the Johnson brothers. Let's go into this parlor right here.
Like the family, understated but elegant.
The Johnsons wanted to enjoy their wealth, but they did not want to show it off.
They would rather share it.
It was the Johnson family motto, be not weary in well-doing.
Harry L. practiced what he preached.
He was the one they've always described as being more empathetic with all the needs of the workers.
Developing company benefits like the medical coverage and the EJ housing program.
A little over 4,000 homes for the employees.
Those homes became a foundation for the growing village.
We look at the north side of Johnson City and it's peppered with the EJ neighborhood, house neighborhoods.
But changes were coming to Johnson City and the world. The start of World War I meant difficult decisions for a man who felt responsible for his workers and their families.
And it was a time that weighed heavily on Harry L.'s mind and on his heart because he had to reduce worker benefits.
Worried about his workers putting food on their tables, Harry L. took it upon himself.
This actually used to be Harry L.'s potato field, which he planted during World War I.
He had his lawn plowed up so that they could grow potatoes on his lawn.
Harry L. died just 3 years after the war ended. The family says it was a hunting accident. He wasn't even 50 years old.
He bought it in 1930. So back in the day, the Johnsons would come to the funeral home to pay respects for all of the Endicott Johnson workers.
The Barber family bought the house in 1930 and converted it into a memorial home. But the connection between the Johnsons and the Barbers goes back farther than that.
They would come in, sign the book in private with the family to pay their respects, and then quietly leave so that nobody had known that they came except for the family that was here.
That was before the move in the 1920s when the funeral home was on Broad Street. Kyla Barber says all three brothers would be there and not one employee was overlooked.
So my grandfather had to have the funeral home opened at a specific time when he knew that the Johnsons would come.
That was private. But so many of the Johnsons' contributions are more public, and there are plenty of them just on Main Street. From Harry L.'s house to the American Legion named after their father, and Sarah Jane Johnson Church in honor of their mother, and the library, which was a gift from Harry L.
His portrait hangs in the front hallway of your home library as a reminder to all of us that we could thank him for this wonderful resource in our community.
In Johnson City, for Fox 40 HD News, I'm Amy Hogan.